He has done so much for Goan musicians and singers. In fact, he brought, you know, the standard of, he has lifted the standard of music and singing and choral music, especially in Goa. And most of us who were part of the university choir, and even those who have come in and come in sometimes, we have learned a lot from him, and he's contributed a lot to us.
Any pleasant memory, particular time?
There were many actually, but I have been for some of them. I think the Kater one was the last one. This year, that is 2021, that was his last one, which we had recorded here at Museum of Christian Art. And that was the last one with him. And then soon after that, the next following month, something, he passed away.
Inspiring person would push you all forward?
Very much, very much. And he was the kind of a pusher. He would just push you. And he believed in us somehow. And, you know, we didn't know much initially. And then he helped us to... he taught us some things in between and held workshops for us. And he had workshops for conductors, musicians, and, you know, spoke about other things as well, like arranging music and all. And that helped us to get better insight from the music, not just perform it for kind of a showing off kind of thing, but, you know, how to get deeper meaning into the piece and how to get that out first, you know. And then that is what will connect with the audience. You know, so things like that he would explain to us.
One sentence about yourself.
About myself?
I know you're a modest guy, but you've done a lot.
About what to say?
Music.
Me?
Teach music.
I teach music.
It's your passion.
Performing as well. Performing.
Eat, sleep, and teach music.
Yeah, I like to arrange also music. That's another passion.
I liked your carols and your.
I'm trying to get more into that eventually.
You have a group in Moira, no?
No, it's my choral group. It's from based in North Goa, from different places. But I'm trying to get more into that now. Now since I've got into teaching for quite some time and performing also. But then I want to do more into arranging music and performing those pieces as well.
Great.
Even instrumental, choral, whatever it may be, but something arranged.
Thank you. Yes. Thank you so much.
That thing, I don't have any episode to...
So what do you remember of Girelli?
I remember of Girelli as a man who mastered his music. He was a master, really a maestro. And when he came to Goa, was exactly to promote music, Western classical music. And I had this group, Stuti. He told me, let us work together. Because this chair is exactly to promote Western classical music. Then he said, in the course of time, we will have people, artists from abroad, coming here to play with us and things. Then I told him in one of those concerts, I said, Maestro, you bring people of top quality, I said. The violin, the one who played the violin solo for Telemann's Viola Concerto, was a player of high standard, I said. Yes, they are professionals, and my aim also is to bring such people here to Goa. That was one
what
thing.
Do you see as his contribution, Father, to Goa?
Yes, I see that he brought people together. People, not necessarily from the university.
Correct.
Not many people from the university.
It was open to everyone.
It was open to everyone. And he created a choir of good quality, high quality. I can tell
what's
you
the loss? What's the loss?
The loss for me is that we lost a man of art. Musical art. He had art. And that is the...
Father, they want you.
Oh, yes, sir.
Whenever I enter Santa Monica, my first memory is of Santiago standing here in the front of us, one trouser leg rolled up, one down, and just making us sound so beautiful.
Which year?
We started, I joined the choir in 2015.
From the start, you were there from day one?
No, not
okay.
Really. The choir began in 2013, but I joined in 2015. But I was there ever since the first Ketevan Sacred Music Festival.
And he built it up over the years?
He built it up over the years with all of us. And this church was so much part of the festival, part of all our choir concerts, our recordings. And
what were the challenges for him?
For him?
To build it up?
It was really difficult because we are not almost none of us are professional singers.
Totally disparate group, no?
So almost nobody reads music. Okay. So for him to build up a choir that could, you know, sing classical music without being able to read music like a community choir was really,
and
was
totally
really
disparate,
something.
Totally disparate group.
Just
all different
just
backgrounds.
Like absolutely.
And what was the criteria? You didn't need to read music. You just
nothing.
Had to.
Nothing. You just had to.
Enthusiasm.
Yeah, more enthusiasm than anything.
Regular practices.
Regular practices at the Goa University, and just a wish to sing.
Strict
together.
Person. Strict yeah. Person.
Not at all.
Happy.
It was
easy
lovely,
to get along.
Easy to get along with. Not strict at all, and was just welcoming of anybody joining who wanted to join his choir.
Thank you.
Even people who couldn't sing.
Thanks so much. Yeah.
It's bittersweet today singing a tribute concert to Santiago. I think we've got great memories of being here with him. All of us galvanized by his excitement more than anything else about being here, putting it together. I think we all have visuals of like one pant leg rolled up and the other one down, still tying his nada in so many ways. And just the sheer focus and concentration that he got to when it came to time to perform. But also knowing and being able to see as we performed and as we watched his face, and this is something the audience never saw, but you could see on his face with every bead of sweat that rolled down how connected he was to the music, whether it was his own compositions, whether it was something else. And he engendered in so many of us a love for not just classical, because many people do classical, but contemporary classical and contemporary sacred music. And it was new in many ways to us, but it was something that we kind of learned to roll with, and that was something that you had to do when you were with Santiago. You had to roll with the punches because you never knew how things could change, which is why very often we'd had people that would come in the audience and we'd end up never spotting them because eyes needed to be glued to him. Old Goa is bittersweet. He's here. This is his final resting place. Yes, he's across the street in the cemetery of the St. Catherine Parish. A beautiful spot, great for a visit as well. And hopefully he watches over us in all that we do with music.
Very
and
motivating in his approach. He taught you all a lot?
He taught us a lot. He expected a lot. And I think most times we did as much as we could just to keep him happy. Not so much. There were times when obviously everybody goes through fatigue.
Yeah.
But he did as much as, if not more, than we did.
And was he happy with the results?
Sometimes.
Yeah.
Often.
I see.
Often. You know.
The shows went well.
And if ever something didn't really go off well, I think most times the audience didn't know it because it wasn't music that was very that was one of the things. We didn't do music that was very familiar to an audience.
Very global.
Yes. So it gave us a bit of a
leeway.
There was a safety net.
Margin of error.
Because people weren't always familiar with it. So if you did, we didn't sing very popular pieces. But at the same time, I think we...
He knew.
And he gave that to Goa. He gave an exposure to, or a window into music or stuff that was happening beyond what was conventionally known within the classical music space. And I think that really is his greatest legacy to even us as singers. We were a choir of 50 singers today, and I don't think that's ever happened before, with the exception of the time that we went and sang at the NCPA when we joined with a whole bigger Kazakh choir. But Parvesh definitely intends to keep music going. So quite early next year, I think we will be regrouping. Plans are afoot to do maybe more than just sacred music, to explore so much more that we can do. And I think it's given us a new appreciation, a renewed appreciation for just the gift of being able to sing, because we haven't been able to do it for so long.
Yeah.
It's been a year that stripped us of everything. like, you know, including the ability to just meet, connect, sing out for whatever reason. And I think Parvesh can give us that. He's
Everyone has done a great job in that sense. Yeah. And it's so important, Runa, what all you all do. Yeah. I think we need to remind ourselves of that.
Yeah.
Thanks, and all the best.
Thank you. Thanks for